This is a two-component adhesive. Load the guns with the attached adhesive tube, pull off the cap, and press a small amount of adhesive onto a cloth. This enables you to ensure that only fresh adhesive is utilized if you are reusing a cartridge which has already been opened. Only now do you attach the mixing tube. Before you begin with the adhesion, you must ensure that the adhesive surfaces are completely free of dirt and grease. Use the Terrason FL cleaner. Then apply a small amount of adhesive to a plastic spatula and spread the material from the rear evenly over the adhesive surface on the vehicle. Then inspect the adhesive seam with a mirror. Use the same method to apply the adhesive to the adhesive surface on the new part. In addition, then apply the Sikaflex 221 sealant to the contact surfaces on the chassis struts. Lift the prepared new part using magnetic grips and carefully fit it on the vehicle. When inserting the panel, ensure that you do not smear the adhesive. Use clamps to fix the bottom edge of the panel in place again. Then wipe the surface below the adhesive area and attach multiple trim strip clamps. Tighten these until a panel is cleanly and firmly positioned, but without bending it. The panel can now be riveted. Now rivet all of the holes previously drilled. Now it is time to use a spot welder. Use this to weld the bead on the lower edge. We recommend using this attachment to weld the flange on the mudguard. When unassisted, it will take at least 48 hours for the adhesive to harden to its final strength. You can use an infrared lamp set to 30 degrees to achieve the initial bond strength in 60 minutes. Then turn the heat lamp up to 60 degrees. The final bond strength is then reached 90 minutes later. Conventional programmable heating pads can shorten the hardening process in a similar manner. You can remove the trim strip clamps once the adhesive has hardened. Attach the ground contact for the handheld welding torch to the chassis, and then spot weld the front join. Repeat the procedure with the rear flange. After painting, this join will be filled with the black sealant used previously. The sealant completely covers the weld points. As such, work the weld points so that they do not protrude. The rear weld points also have to be cleaned so that they do not impair the installation of the tail light. Use a grinding disc to remove any protruding adhesive residue. Then use an eccentric sander to expose the areas above and below the adhesive points. Then clean the area with a compressed air gun and treat the surfaces with Bondrite cloths. Then load the tube with the tin replacement, Terracal 5010. Apply a regular bead to the surface below the adhesive join. Use a plastic spatula to spread the replacement tin and model the design groove. The replacement tin must then be left to harden for 12 hours. Sand the surface again before painting. Wear a breathing mask and gloves when sanding. Sand the surface of the groove and check whether it is cleanly shaped. Then sand the neighboring paint surfaces again with the eccentric sander. Use the FL Plus cleaner to clean the sanded area. The vehicle is now ready for the body shop. After painting, the hollow surfaces must be treated with preservative and all of the remaining attachments fitted. Then the vehicle is ready to be handed over to the customer. The damage has been repaired cost-effectively, quickly, and professionally. The Akubus Direct Media Library is your film library for all of the films presented on this or one of the other shows.